absolutely furious. Hooper gets in touch there. And I think Dougie McDonald is waiting for the advantage here. He can't get the advantage. He wants to get a shot away. There's the dive. He takes him out. Dougie McDonald is perfectly right to call that as a penalty. Oh, he's changed his mind. He's seen it's a drop ball.
Well, this is extraordinary.
Here. Now, when you see Hooper drawing it in here, it's a touch away. The keeper gets a touch of the ball. Then the linesman makes his way behind the goal. He makes his way behind the goal because at this point, Hugh McDonald has made the decision.
I don't think Mick Bridges are sending off. And the reason I'm saying that, if Mick Bridges are sending off, what I asked him at half-time, he says it was because he barged in to the referee, and that was never the case. I've seen it, it was never the case. Now he's saying it was because he kicked the ball at him. So, you know, he's changed his mind, which is very disappointing. But, you know, we're on it together, and I can understand that. And yet, we're talking about fourth officials getting involved. I'm standing next to him, there's about 10 bodies in there, and yet he picks my bride up. I think it's a case of knowing what he was going to do. He was going to send Lafferty off. Don't think that was merited a straight red card, but he was going to send him off when he went, I better even this up, and that's the way it went.
I've been listening to the programme since 6 o'clock, and you know, it's very frustrating that we criticise referees when they get things wrong, and now we're criticising them when they get things right. I think I agree with what Graham has said, that I think the decision was eventually correct. I didn't think it was a penalty either. It's very interesting, first of all, the point that Graham said. The assistant referees are now encouraged to become more involved and offer more opinion to the referee. At the end of the day, the referee's decision is final after he's consulted with the rest of his team. The other three match officials, including the fourth official, are obviously all wired. They're all communicating with each other. And when the decision was made, the assistant referee, Dougie McDonald, asked the assistant referee what kind of angle he had on it. And there's a really good picture 10 minutes after the incident, which was the camera from the offside line in the main stand, which clearly shows that the assistant referee has got a first-class view and clearly sees the ball changing direction by the action of the goalkeeper when he touches the ball with his hands. So Dougie then got that information, exchanged information with the assistant referee, and the game is restarted with a drop ball. And, you know, in my opinion also, that decision was correct.